Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like the diamond in the sky.
Hello and welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you are joining me from any part of the world, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so you'll be notified each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Remember, in this channel, I bring you information on things that are happening in Nigeria, when it happened, where it happened, and how it happened. And today, I will share with you a video of an interview that was granted to the lawyer of the Supreme Leader of IPOB, the Supreme Leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, by the press. As you all know, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu was supposed to appear in court, but the DSS refused to bring him in court. The lawyers were there, several lawyers from the southeastern part of Nigeria and other international lawyers were there to defend him. But yet, the DSS shied away from the case. Now, let us hear directly from the senior lawyer of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Aloy Ifeanyi Ejiofo, to know what actually transpired in the court. Let's watch carefully. After watching, go to the comment section, comment, and also subscribe to the channel. Let's watch.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. Thank you very much. I am glad to be with you this afternoon.
Thank you so much.
Today is 26th of July.
Yes.
2021,
yes.
And today happens to be a great day for Biafrans all over the world.
Sure.
And I strongly believe that today is supposed to be the day that our leader will appear on court. A lot of people were outside, a lot were given an opportunity to be in the court to see undergo the proceedings, but we find out that it is only you that can tell Biafran actually what happens today. The way it is. Welcome to the program and talk to Biafrans regards to what played out today in the court. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. We thank God for a day like this. We must give thanks to God Almighty for gift of life and also for what happened in court today. Because what they expected, the enemies actually expected, didn't happen. I must also commend people who, despite all the intimidations, threats, from possible arrest and all whatnot, were able to be in court today. So, and the crowd was overwhelming. I must commend them for being there to witness the proceedings of the court, despite the fact they were not allowed to come in. But at least the most important thing that the message has been sent passed to the authorities to understand that Nnamdi Kanu is not standing alone in this situation. So today, the matter actually came for commencement of trial, hearing. So a continuation of hearing, kind of, because the matter has been in court. So you are away on the manner in which he was brought to court on 29th of June this year, without our knowledge, without reference to us. He was brought to after being kidnapped in Kenya, and he was smuggled into Nigeria through extraordinary rendition. So which process we have been challenged today before the International Court and also African Union Court. And also within the foreign space is being challenged today. So on 29, nobody notified us. And I informed the court today. I expressed my concern to court about what happened today. I registered my concern before the court today about the manner in which it was brought to court. And also let the court understand that the court, I am the substantive counsel in this suit, in this case. By virtue of which position, the prosecution, being the federal government of Nigeria, should have notified me about the excise, I will call it excise, that took place on 29th of June. You have notified me, first of all, that he was arrested or abducted. So, and also, so I will be in court on 29th to see what they want to do. So, and I was able to register my concerns and my apprehension too, because I know I was laying foundation for something. And I specifically asked my lord to take it on record, because I was, by so doing, I'm trying to lay a foundation for what will happen in the course of time. So he was brought to court on 29th, Then the court ordered for him to be murdered in desert custody. So we have also filed an application to get him transferred to Correctional Center Kuje, where we have all access to him. And the fact that we don't have easy access to him was also brought to the attention of the court, because we should have access, all the access to him at all times as his lawyers. So we brought attention of the court, which was substantially resolved today, and the other court made order when we were in chambers, because eventually we retired to chambers, where that those issues were resolved, and court directed the authority, telling him to at least allow us time, within substantial time, to see him weekly. So it's an order of court now. So the manner in which to visit him has been specified, which can then accommodate people outside lawyers to come through us and see him. So once the person indicates interest to see him, so it's not only lawyers now that can see him. The relatives, the friends can as well see him through us. So that has been resolved today substantially. Then two, in view of the fact that vacation commenced today, Friday Court vacation, the court didn't dwell much into the proceedings of today, what the business of today, because before the proceedings of today will be effective in the eyes of the law, in view of the declaration of vacation which commenced today, the court will have a fiat. There must be a fiat authorizing the court to continue the proceedings during vacation. So the court also raised those concerns that he may not dwell much into the activities of today in view of the fact that the direction of the Federal High Court commenced today. Okay. And also courts let us understand at the point he was given this date on 29th of June 2021, that he never had in mind that vacation will commence today. Okay. And so we are going to do the effort to ensure the CJ to secure the fiat of CJ for his lordship to continue trial during vacation. So the court tentatively adjourned the matter to 21st of October, pending when the fiat is obtained. So if the fiat is given between now and the probably next 2 weeks or 1 week, then the court can call back the case and give us a fresh date for the trial to commence. And so that actually affected the court's well much into our application to get him transferred to prison. And also, of course, you know the style of the federal government in this case. That has been their style, their practice. They filed a response to this application, which we filed on 14th of July, and served on them. Application for him to transfer to prison custody, to correctional center. So they responded for 8 hours after, and decided to withheld their response, their counter affidavit to our application, only to be ambushed with this application this morning, their response this morning. Mm. So apparently, they were thinking that if this matter is going on, as been the matter is going on today, we'll go on today, that our application will not be taken, because that has been their style. And I condemn it to open court. And I profusely condemn it. I told the court, I registered my annoyance, that this practice has to stop. The matter is taking a different dimension. And the international community is following up. Because this matter has so many legs now. Of course, I can wear. You're away now. So it's before many international courts. Before international court, before the African Union court. So international community are fully involved in this case, this part of the game. It's no longer the case of 2015, where he was arrested and brought to Abuja. Order was given for him to be released. Then those orders were flouted by the federal government. Until when we got 8 counts out of 11 counts charged, struck out by the government, that was when he was granted bail to 25th of April 2017. So before the subsequent invasion of his premises on 14th of September 2017, wherein over 28 persons were murdered in an attempt to assassinate him. This is a person that was beat to be in court on October 17th. So those parts is a different scenario. So we're able to bring that to the attention of the court today, that what is playing out now is not the scenario of 2015. Mm. That we are talking about somebody who was kidnapped in Kenya. British citizen who was kidnapped in Kenya. We're talking about British who was abducted in Kenya, smuggled in here, in clear violation of international convention protocol, and in clear violation of UN convention of 201, which Nigeria signed as a party. That's what we're talking about today in court. So, and the court was also let to know that international community is interested, is involved in this case. And this matter, the other legs of this, arms of this matter, before the international courts. We brought that attention of the court to understand today. Because we are talking about image of this country. If at all there's anyone left over, which have been battered and destroyed before the international community. Yeah, so you can't just go in a foreign land, abduct a citizen of a different country, and bring it to this country for a trial, a political trial for that matter. So that has been laid to bear before the court today. So we intend to respond to the application, the fine, which was filed, first of all, serve us on us out of time. We have to respond to it. For the meantime, we are going to explore the avenue of communicating, establishing communication with CJ, so to ensure that the court is giving fiat to handle this matter during this vacation. So that is what we are doing now. So now it is important also to point out that the government of the Nigerian government has made heavy word about amending charge, introducing case of murder, terrorism, kidnapping, and all whatnot. There was no charge amended as of today. We are in court today. I was expecting. I even went to them and said, "I heard about the amendment you are talking. You talked about over the media that we are going to see. So we are going to see a case of murder today. We are going to see a case of kidnapping today. We are going to see a case of bandit today. We are going to see a case of name them." Today, as I speak to you, there was no form of amendment to the charge. Though we are not quite worried about that. My worry is stem on the fact from the fact that he was not in court. So, which they said it was on account of logistic issues. So, but I know they are being careful about about vacation, because apparently, even if he was in court, it's possible the matter will not go on, because today vacation commences today. I know that one very well. So, but we are able to achieve something. First of all, the court has given us, made an order allowing us to see him. So, and also mentioned to the court that it was all over the media yesterday that he was taking whiskey away from Abuja. So that it should confirm from them. But there's also expressed concern. So let me know why my client is in his position and all. So that was why the court was even so eager to make the order to ensure we see him. So, and let it stand an order of court. So we're not seeing him now at the ledger, right? At the convenience of the SSL. We are seeing him now at the convenience of the court. So unlike then, when they will call us to come around 6 o'clock in the night, in the evening, and see him, we'll stay there till 9 o'clock. They will call you, they will have to approve your request to see him. Those days have gone. Now the court has specified it, see him and time. So we are now to see any day there's a violation of that court order. The court said I should come to the court and report. And tell the court and report immediately that you know waste time. That's the instruction from the court. So we are going to take it off from there. But I can assure you that he's fine. At least I can assure you that from every investigation we made after the hearing, those informations are not true. Information about taking him elsewhere are not true. So I may not be able to mention our source, but they're not true. But we'll see him any moment from in the next couple of maybe by Wednesday, they will see him. So in line with all that, you see him go, and I will also get back to you people as to how he's doing. And so now we are at liberty to see him at the discretion of the court, the manner which directed. So thank you.
Thank you very much, Rabasta. Secondly, I would like to know from you, what is the international stand on this case, regards to your client?
Thank you so much. I must tell you, I'm very much delighted by the interest taken by the international community. I need to mention this to people to understand. Already this afternoon, I had a very, 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 very serious communication from U.S. Embassy. So, and they are following up. So, and also, we are having also correspondences from other